Good morning students, this is Sheba. Now we are going to see about the electronic devices, unit 1, semiconductor diodes. In our previous sessions, we have discussed about the basics of cell electronics, semiconductor diodes, PN junction diode, its applications, current density of PN junction diodes, energy band gap diagram and its parameters. So now we are going to discuss about the transition and diffusion capacitance of PN junction diode. What is mean by this transition capacitance? Talking in general about the capacitance of the PN junction diode, here in PN junction, the capacitance of the reverse bias of PN junction diode decreases when voltage increases. That is, the amount of capacitance changed with increase in voltage is called transition capacitance. It is also known as depletion region junction capacitance or barrier capacitance. This transition capacitance is the change of charge stored in the depletion region with respect to change in voltage. Talking about the diffusion capacitance, it is the capacitance caused due to the movement of charge carriers between anode to cathode in forward biased mode or forward biased condition. So, talking about transition capacitance, you can clearly say it is the change of charge stored in the depletion region with respect to voltage change, whereas diffusion capacitance is movement of charge carriers between anode to cathode in forward bias condition. Here, moving to the calculations of transition capacitance, the parallel layers of oppositely charged immobile ions of the two sides of junction form the capacitance CT, that is transition capacitance. So, you can say it as transition capacitance or space charge or depletion diffusion capacitance. CT is equal to modulus of dq divided by dv, where dq is the increase in charge and dv is the change in voltage. The total charge density of a p-type material with the area of junction A is given by q is equal to q na into w into A. We know that q is the charge and n is the number of acceptor ions, w is the diffusion width, that is width of the depletion region. So, based on this value, we will be finding the values of total charge density. And you can see diagrammatic representation of this transition capacitance. Here, first one, with respect to charge density, I have drawn the diagram and of Na and Nd. Second one is for potential. Based on the potential value, the distribution of the capacitance is given. The relation between potential and charge density is given by the Poisson's equation, that is d square v by dx square is equal to minus rho divided by epsilon naught epsilon r. We have derived in this previous session itself, its value is equal to q na divided by epsilon naught epsilon r. From this we can calculate the value of v. At x is equal to wp and v is equal to vb, vb is equal to q na w square divided by 2 epsilon. Differentiating this value with respect to v, we get I is equal to. So we are getting the value 1 is equal to q na divided into 2w divided by 2 epsilon modulus of dw divided by dv. From this we are cross multiplying the values and we are getting the value of modulus of dw divided by dv. So I need the value of ct is equal to modulus of dq by dv and I am substituting this value at that place aq na instead of w. I am substituting this value. So now, I can rewrite the equation as Ct is equal to epsilon A divided by W. So this is the transition capacitance. Its value can range 20 picofarad at zero bias condition and under biasing, forward biasing, its values can range from 5 to 200 picofarad. Moving to the diffusion capacitance, as I have said earlier, this diffusion capacitance is nothing but the capacitance due to transport of charge carriers between two terminals of the device, that is from anode to cathode in forward bias condition. So this is the capacitance that exists in forward bias condition. It is also known as storage capacitance. CD, diffusion capacitance, is always greater than the transition capacitance. It's equal to DQ divided by V. As we have seen, DQ is represent the change in number of minority carrier when change in voltage occurs. We know Q is equal to integral of 0 into infinity AE PN of 0 e power minus x divided by LP into dx. So from this I am finding the value of, so I am simplifying, applying integration and finding the value as LP AE PN of 0. Now diffusion hold current in inside region IPN of x, I am taking that value at x is equal to 0 condition I am applying, and then IPN of 0 is approximately equal to I. I am substituting that value and I am finding the value of PN of 0. Now I am differentiating it with respect to V and I am finding the value of CD is equal to DQ by V is equal to DI divided by DV LP square divided by DP. So now from diode current equation I am finding the value of G is equal to I divided by epsilon into VT. So I am simplifying the equation as CD is equal to G tau. Since G is equal to I divided by epsilon into VT, I can rewrite it as CD is equal to tau I divided by epsilon into VT. There are some parametric considerations for this diffusion capacitance, that is CD always increases for forward bias condition and it is negligible for reverse bias. Its range is from 10 picofarad to 1000 picofarad and it is high for low frequency and low for high frequency. This is about the transition capacitance and diffusion capacitance of PN junction diode. So before applying to the any application of PN junction, for example, if you are applying it as a rectifier, if you are applying it as a detector in any communication devices, you need to find its storage and its retrieval capacity. What is the capacitance value it reproduces under forward bias and under reverse bias condition? So for doing this and all, you need to find this transition and diffusion capacitance value. This is about the transition and diffusion capacitance. If you have any doubts in this, you can ask me and get the details. Thank you.